Hey everyone, Bryn here. And if you can't tell, I love Star Wars, and I love making movies, and I've even tried my hand at making some Star Wars movies. To, you know, varying degrees of success. And what I also love is seeing Star Wars fan films on YouTube. And I'm not just talking about the huge, big budget ones that go all out. I'm talking about the smaller ones made by just a group of fans, using their ingenuity, talent, and time to bring us into a world far, far away. So I thought I'd share some of the assets I've found and some of the lessons I've learned from the mistakes I've made making my own Star Wars fan film so that you can make your own Star Wars fan film. This video will cover everything from finding and making props and costumes to editing and sound effects, visual effects, really whatever you need to make your own Star Wars fan film, all the missing pieces that you get from normal filmmaking. Which, by the way, this is not a video tutorial on how to make films or video production of any kind. For that kind of stuff, I highly recommend checking out Quarter Crew or Film Riot. Those are two amazing channels where you can learn a lot just by watching their videos. That's where I've learned a lot the last few years, and they're really, really amazing. It's on par with the stuff I learned taking video production classes. It is very good. I highly recommend it. Also, disclaimer, if you're under 18 and you're going to take my advice in like making costumes and props and stuff, please have parental supervision if you're going to use any type of tools, hot glue guns, anything. I'm not responsible if you get yourself hurt, okay? So first off, I want to talk about a mistake I made and how you can learn from this. First off is when choosing your locations and writing your script, try not to use existing locations around you, because that's the first big thing that takes people out of it. For example, one of my mistakes, I tried to make my high school when I was 16 look like a Jedi temple for the little Kylo Ren fan film we did that did not turn out that great. And I got a lot of comments about the bike rack and the voltage meter and a few other things that we couldn't remove with visual effects that really took people out of it. So try to either use abandoned areas like forests, or if you live near mountains, maybe snow for like an ice planet, deserts if you live near one, things like that. Things that don't have signs of modern human civilization. And also just use like your basement or a room and decorate it to look like a Star Wars set. As far as building set goes, you can get a lot done with just building PVC frames for the like surrounding of your set if you're not just decking out a whole room, and using cardboard and poster board and things like that to sort of make panels on it. That's like the simple thing for making sets. It doesn't work that well for anything but Star Wars or maybe some medieval stuff, but it's really good for that. And you can then deck it all out with some hoodies or some arbesh. Probably pronouncing both of those wrong. My apologies, Star Wars nerds. Please don't cancel me. I'm going to link to the fonts for hoodies and arbesh in the description so you can go and download those, print out stencils for them, paint them on your sets, do all that fun stuff. There's also this really cool design that they use in a lot of Star Wars things, this very oval grate type thing. If you put that on, cut it out of some sets, maybe put some cheesecloth or some kind of diffuser behind it, and then put a light behind it, you get this really nice effect that you can use for making sets. It's really, really good, and I highly recommend it. Now, costumes is a very simple one. If you don't have a lot of experience making costumes, thrift shops are gonna be your best friend here. The two main things you want to avoid, and these are things you can take off of, things you find at the thrift store easily if it doesn't fit, is visible buttons and back pockets. Those are two things that they, for some reason, almost never have in Star Wars. There's one character in the background of A New Hope with buttons, and then Poe Dameron has back pockets in one of his outfits in Rise of Skywalker, and that's pretty much it. It's very rare. But for any armored part of your costume, let's say you want to put like some shoulder pads on them or some kind of chest plate for like a bounty hunter or something, I highly recommend, if you don't have a budget, doing EVA foam, because that stuff is amazing to work with, and there are some awesome channels on YouTube that'll show you how to get going with it really fast. For example, my very first build with EVA foam that had a pattern with it was this, and I was like 17 at the time. This is my first time really working with it, besides a prototype I did when I was a little bit younger, and it turned out pretty good, I'd say. It doesn't look as good as it did when it first came out, but I'd say it turned out really well, and you can easily make something like that in more of a Star Wars style. There's a lot of patterns and templates on Etsy for EVA foam that are really amazing. Some of them even are Star Wars ones, so highly recommend using that. You need to buy this stuff, go to tntcosplaysupply.com. They are an amazing place for you to buy foam at a very nice, affordable price. You can also get it on Amazon and at stores like Michael's and Joann's, but it's gonna be a little more expensive those places. Now, as far as weapons and props goes, let's start with the easiest one, blasters. Blasters are really easy. You can make blasters that look really nice like these for like like 10 bucks each. Because what you can do is just go buy the Ruby's costume blasters on Amazon, get them, paint them, and they turn out looking really good. Like, this just cost me about 10 bucks, and I followed a tutorial by Cosplay Chris, who's an amazing cosplayer, amazing prop maker. You should totally check him out on how to paint this into a realistic looking Han Solo blaster. And it even makes sounds. Cool, right? And the same with this Boba Fett one. This is one I didn't have a tutorial for, but it's the same basic principle. It's a blaster that they sold at Disney World originally that is now on sale at, like, Amazon and everything. And it's really cool. It works. It does the job. And on screen for a budgeted fan film, it's gonna look great. For lightsabers, there are two different ways to do it. The first way, if you want light cast on to your actors by the lightsabers, is to buy a lightsaber from Ultra Sabers. You can get a base one for around like $50, and then you can just deck it out with like model kit pieces around the handle to make it look like a really nice custom lightsaber. That is, if it's gonna show up in a close-up on screen. Otherwise, don't even worry about it. If you do wanna do that though, there's an awesome tutorial by Master and Apprentice from Rooster Teeth that I'll leave a link to in the description down below. It'll teach you all how to do that. The second method is a little more dangerous. So you're gonna wanna get some 48-inch driveway marker fiberglass rods. They're come in huge packs on Amazon for very cheap. You get a whole bunch of them. And then all you have to do really is wrap the end of one, maybe put some rubber on one and a couple of tracking dots or something, and then just make a handle around it the same way you would do with the Ultra Sabers one. This won't cast light on your subject, but it'll give you a nice stick that you can use to track where you'll put your lightsaber in visual effects later, which we'll get to in just a second. And if you're using like a bunch of different Jedi all fighting or something, this is a great thing to have. And then maybe just have one or two Ultra Saber ones for any close-up shots or for the main two Jedi or Sith that are going at it, so that you can really get some cool lighting effects going on there. Speaking of lightsabers and blasters, let's get on to visual effects. The first thing we're gonna cover is how to make the blaster bolts and the lightsaber blades, which you can do with this awesome free add-on by Video Copilot called Saber. It works really well, it's amazing, it is an add-on for Adobe After Effects, so if you don't have that, that is gonna be a downfall, but you can usually get an older version of this, and this works with older versions of it. You can go check out all the info, I'm leaving a link down in the description below to the add-on. It's really amazing, I highly recommend checking it out. Now, for any CGI you need in this, for hordes of stormtroopers or for spaceships, you can get models that are rigged and ready to go for characters, and you don't need a rig for a spaceship one, obviously, on Sketchfab or DeviantArt for free. I'm going to leave some links to some of my favorite ones down below. They're amazing, and you can just get them, put them in Blender, and you're ready to go. Some of these you'll need an XPS LoRa add-on to import them in, which you can figure out all that. But it's really great. I highly recommend using this for if you need a giant army of stormtroopers in the background, or if you need a spaceship flying by. It is so good, and it is so at your fingertips. It's amazing how technology has come, because originally if you wanted to do spaceships or an army of people, you need to have a giant matte painting like they did for Return of the Jedi with the giant hangar for the Emperor and Darth Vader's arrival, or you need to build a meticulous model, and then as soon as you blew it up, it was gone. You couldn't do it anymore. Now technology is so at our fingertips, it doesn't look as good in some ways, but it's right there, and anyone can use it, and anyone can. It is free, it works on almost any level of laptop if you just give it enough time to render. It's awesome. I highly recommend looking into all of this. Now the last part, sound design and music. Okay, so a lot of this you're gonna wanna just kinda look through like royalty-free sound effect stuff online. There's some places like Incompetech that do some awesome music that sounds very John Williams-y. But there is another option that's much easier that everyone does, so if you wanna stand out a bit from this, you can, you know, go the extra mile. But I'm gonna leave a link in the description below to a drive file I've made of it, and that is the Star Wars Fan Film Awards Sound and Music Pack. This is what they give out to everyone to use as the royalty-free music and sound for the competition, and they take down the link to it every time they're not running the competition, but I have it downloaded, I'm putting it in the drive, so you can download it literally any time of year, and you can just start using it. And disclaimer, the music in it is not actually from the movies. It is some very similar sounding things. I think it's from one of their mobile games, I'm not 100% sure, but when you use it, it doesn't automatically flag your video for copyright on YouTube, which is awesome. And then all the sound effects are from the movies. Tons of lightsabers, blaster bolts, things like that. It's amazing and definitely worth using for any Star Wars fan film you're doing, even if it's just for one or two sound effects in there that you've been looking for. So thank you guys for watching. I super appreciate all of you. You're amazing. If you want to support us, there's a link to the Patreon down below where you get your name credited at the end, like these wonderful people here, which are all amazing, and I highly recommend you checking it out. We have some little behind-the-scenes things. We have HD downloads of some of the posts on our Spider-Man 4 fan film Instagram. It's awesome. And I'm going to keep trying to put out videos like this, both during the downtime and then still going on through the production of Spider-Man 4 and everything, just so I can have something out for you guys. Leave a comment down below on like what other kinds of fan films you'd like to see, kind of cheat sheets for on where to find all the resources to make. Not Spider-Man, because I'm definitely going to do that eventually after we get like the teaser out and a few other things so that I can kind of use that as an example of what to do. Because that is being made for a very bare bones budget. I think you guys would really like some of the techniques we use for your own fan films if that's what you're doing. Well, everyone, have a great day. During this time of crisis, stay home, stay safe, and may the Force be with you.